Hello, my name is Bill and welcome to Mind Your Crypto. Today I have an Ankr update. Let's see some recent price action as well do the price prediction for the very short term. If you want to help me guys, please hit the like button, subscribe, hit the bell button to turn all the notifications on and share of course the videos. It is very important, and of course you can join our Telegram group chat where we discuss about more and more. Let's see now the support and resistance levels and what we are looking for in Ankr. Let's see the volume. The volume right here, guys, we had this huge sell pressure right here. You can see this big red candle and we went all the way downwards. We didn't have any volume at all. You can see it by the candles as well. And now we want to make sure that we have a bit of a volume here for Ankr. We want to make the 12 cents, 12 to 13 cents as our support level and bounce between those levels. And of course, if we can extend the 15 to 16 cents, then we will be having a clear buying opportunity, but I will discuss about this later. Right now, we have some lower support levels in case Bitcoin corrects more, 10 cents, and of course, the 0.09. We will see about that though. Right now, I will take this back to the minus 0.618 Fibonacci retracement, 10 cents, okay? So we got 11, 10 cents, and of course the 12 cents to 13 cents that we want to make our support level for now. Let's see a bit about the MACD. I like what it will do here. If it will do this, guys, I like that MACD, it might move upwards. I want it to move upwards, and of course the signal line continuing like this, weight regaining some further more distance between the blue line, the MACD, and the signal line, the orange line. As you can see here, we were consolidating from 17th April a little bit further beyond. You can see the price started to drop around I think 16th April. I'm not sure guys about this. Let's see. No, 17th April. Yeah, 16th to 17th April. The price started to drop. We saw this bearish cross between the signal line and the blue line. And of course, right there, we wanted to consolidate so the EMAs would reach the price. It was all too normal, guys. Of course, a very healthy correction. And of course, Bitcoin corrected more. So we had a furthermore consolidation. Right now, what we want to see is the MACD regaining some strength in the 4-hour frame, going upwards, and of course, regaining some further more distance with the signal line. We go now to RSI. What we want to see here, guys, exactly for me, is breaking this important resistance level for the RSI at 49.250. We want to go above this resistance line so we can see some new higher highs, new higher lows for the Ankr. Right now, it might be the case, guys. We want to see. I'm so impatient to see what Ankr will do, but of course, what Bitcoin will do also. Remember, we are still in a bull run, even if Bitcoin corrects, right? So, what we want to see right now is for the commodity channel index the same. We want to break this level here back on 21st April, and we want to break this resistance level at around 4 to 7 for the commodity channel index around there, guys. So we want to go above this resistance level for the commodity channel index as well, seeing some new higher highs and higher lows. Right now, for the SSL channel in the 4-hour frame, we don't have any buying opportunity, but we will see about that. If we will see if it finds a sell pressure at this line right here, or if it will go more. Let's go to the, we have nothing to discuss here, guys. We are not in an overbought or any oversold situation right now, but that doesn't mean that we don't have a buying opportunity. Let's see now the MACD and of course the Bollinger Bands. I will start first with the MACD. The more the distance between the lines, even if we correct, guys, the more the distance, the more the buying opportunity when the blue line is beyond the signal line. When the blue line is beyond the signal line, we have a more of a buying opportunity. We have such a further distance. As well as here, it was the opposite. When we are having a high distance while the blue line is above the signal line, then we are having a pretty good sell opportunity. We are having a risk where the price might go downwards, okay? So as we go further deep downwards, you might want to buy even more. And of course, for the Bollinger Bands, we have this little squeeze point here, And now we are regaining some volatility. Let's see what we will do for the daily frame. Of course, in the squeeze point right here, guys, you want to buy even more for the mid long term when we are having squeeze points like this back on March. Okay, and of course this high volatility means that we are having a risk, and of course if we extend the Bollinger Bands like this, then we are going downwards. You can see the candles here, they were such a bullish candles, but we were overextending the top of the Bollinger Bands, then we were consolidating back in. Okay, so that's what happens here. We're in the bottom Bollinger Band right now. All we want to see is breaking through some important resistance levels, so we will be sure when to buy or not, so we will minimize the risk. Guys, for Ankr against Bitcoin in the 4-hour frame, what I expect for Ankr in order to grow is, first of all, the 50-day MA crossing the 20-day MA and the 30-day MA, and of course the red line going down while the other ones going upwards. So I want them to cross each other, and of course the 50-day MA go beyond the 20 and the 30-day MA. And I don't want to see the 50-day MA playing the resistance role. I want to see the 50-day MA playing the support role. So I want to see the candles above these lines here. Okay, so that's it for Ankr against Bitcoin in the 4-hour frame. Of course, we want to see some furthermore volume here where we can see the price going upwards, and we want to see Bitcoin not correcting so much more. But Ankr against Bitcoin looks more stronger than Ankr against USDT. The reason is because a Bitcoin falls as well, corrects as well, and we have seen that we stop around this support level for Ankr against Bitcoin. Okay, this support level at around, guys, let's see, 0.50213. That is the support level we want to hold, and of course we want to go upwards. We want to see this nice candle forming here after this cross candle, you can see going upwards again. So let's see Ankr against Bitcoin in the daily frame. What we want to do, let's see a bit the Fibonacci levels. We want to surpass this price here, guys, for Ankr against Bitcoin, the 0.50272. If we surpass this, we might be looking forward to bounce between those lines, because this is our major resistance level for the previous 2 days, 23rd April and 24th April as well. We want to regain some strength. Ankr against Bitcoin looks good, guys, looks strong, because I will tell you this, the 50-day MA is still beyond the 20 and the 30-day MA. That's the most important. And of course, we saw the big buying pressure here. You can see this candle, guys, 23rd April, buying pressure at almost the 50-day EMA or minus 0.5 Fibonacci level, 0.50208. So right now we want to see it going upwards, bouncing back, and of course Bitcoin not correcting even more. Okay, the MACD for the daily frame in Ankr against Bitcoin looks like about the same with the Ankr against USDT. We see here, guys, it looks about the same. You can see here 5 April, it didn't reach the signal line and went for furthermore down. Same with Ankr, same movement. Okay, so what we want to see here is forming new higher highs, new higher lows. And I will tell you what I think about Ankr now in our price analysis. That was our top trend line. What we want to see here is, of course, not to have the 20-day EMA as our resistance point. You can see here we had a bit of a sell pressure. Right now we are forming this nice candle where we might go upwards, but we have a long way to go. And of course, guys, these are the support levels we want to keep for sure. 10 cents, around 10 to 12 cents, 10 to 11, sorry guys, and 10 cents. These are the most important support roles right now. And of course, if we can make the 12 to 13 cents as our support levels, then we will be fine as well. And we need to see the 50-day EMA going above, the 20 and the 30-day EMA again for Ankr against Tether USD. So right now that's what we want to see, and we don't want to see the 10-day MA being the resistance part here. Of course, we want to bounce back and break some important major resistance levels. For example, guys, 15 to 16 cents, of course. And if we can break the 16 to 17 cents, that's even more fine. For me, this here, guys, is a clear buying opportunity. If we break above this target here, and especially, guys, the 60 to 70 cents, then for me, it is a very, very good buying opportunity for Ankr. Right now, if you want my opinion, we should wait a bit and see what the Ankr will do, what we will do for now. Okay, if you want my advice for the mid short term, for the midterm especially, guys, sorry, not for the short term, we might even have a buying opportunity. But right now, guys, if Bitcoin corrects more, then we might fall further down. Okay, so we need to be patient and see some important resistance and support levels. And for me, the resistance level, which I deleted previously, the most important resistance level is right here. And if you want my advice on a buying strategy, because we are still, remember guys, even if Bitcoin corrects more, we are still in a bull run. That means that we should, I think, in my opinion, we should buy the dips, of course, for the mid, if you want to HODL. Okay, if you want to HODL, you should buy the dips. For example, if we had to go down from 12 to 13 cents, if we had to go down from this support line, then we would eventually be looking to buy even more at 11 or at 10 cents if we had to hit this support level again. If that's not the case and Bitcoin goes more and more upwards, doesn't correct, then of course we would be looking at when we break this resistance to minimize the risk. Because guys, I advise you these buying strategies in order to minimize the risk. That's all I care about. You minimize the risk, you might take less profit targets than investing, of course, here or at 12 to 13 cents for the short term. But for me, especially for me, after these many years of experience, guys, of course, not so many years, but as you can see, I have some experience, because for my experience, I want to minimize the risk as well as even if it means to take less profits. Okay, for me, it is better to surely take profits than taking more profits, because you can easily lose money if you panic and sell your position. And of course, guys, if you bought here, for example, at 15 cents or even higher or a bit lower, don't sell your position right now, guys. HODL, stay strong. Of course, remember that we are correcting now, right now, but we are still in a very good bull run. So you need, guys, to HODL for me. You need to HODL your position. Never, never sell. And of course, you can see here the 20-day EMA sell pressure that we have. We want to reach above the 50-day EMA, and we don't want to have the 20-day EMA or the 50-day EMA as our resistance level, like back there, like at 19th April, like at 21st April, like so many times we are seeing right now while we are consolidating. So for me, we have to see the resistance level part that I talked about for the RSI to go above this resistance level right now, guys. And of course, the same for the commodity channel index I talked about before. We have to see the Bitcoin stops correcting, because if it corrects more, then we are looking at further more lower support levels. And of course, while we do that, guys, always remember that when we are correcting on a bullish run, we are having some quite interesting buying opportunities. Always remember this. And of course, correcting isn't always bad. For some people, when we correct more, they buy more. And of course, they HODL and they take profits in the mid-long term. If you are such an investor, then of course, guys, you can buy the dips here. For example, this here buying dip at 23rd April or this was pretty good for the mid-long term. But for now, guys, we have a risk of Bitcoin correcting a little bit more. So for now, we will stay calm. We will see what the price will do. And these are the buying strategies I'm looking at for myself. And of course, this is not financial advice, but I advise you to do the same, guys. Of course, you can always do your own research and do your own thing. This is something that I would do, guys. Of course, the 13 cents, we want to keep this as a support level. And if we have to fall 10 and 11 cents, sorry, and 10 cents, then I would buy more. If we would break this target here, 15 to 16 cents, I would put some money there, not investing, of course, all of my money into one crypto asset. That's something that beginners in crypto space do. The mistake that they are doing is that they are investing in the 16 cents all their money, especially in a crypto asset, in one price, all of their money. They are going FOMO because a friend told us, or because we saw on the news that it will go upwards, and then they panic and sell their position. So you never sell your position, you buy the dip on a bullish run, and of course, guys, you stay calm, being patient, the key to success for the cryptocurrency market, because it has such a high volatility. And of course, we don't have the massive adoption yet, especially for the altcoins. Always remember that. That's why we are seeing 30% action and 40% pumps and corrections in just one day. So here, we want to stop seeing the 20-day MA and 30-day MA and 50-day MA resistance levels, because we might test even lower support levels as the Bitcoin corrects more. Okay, and of course, we want to see higher volume here. We want to make some higher lows. But for now, guys, I suggest you to wait a bit. If you are a new investor, I wouldn't suggest you invest now for the short term. Of course, I'm talking about. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. Have a fantastic day wherever you are. And of course, I will see you soon with many, many more videos to come. And of course, I haven't forgotten, guys, the 1000 subscribers video. But right now, I need for the market to calm a bit, so I will be more sure when what to propose to you for the short term. Thank you, guys, and bye.